Hi, I just want to say, listen to everyone, whoever is going to be watching this video later on. First of all, I just want to say that I want to give all the glory to God. My name is Samantha. I'm Mexican. God gave me the privilege to born in this, place with the name Mexico. But God has been doing a lot of things, and I'm grateful for. It was a time in my life when I came to be like American citizen. I did it. Everything that I could in my side to try to get paperwork in USA and Texas, but then from somehow God would never let me, and I will go and do something else to try to get papers, and it was not working. And I was pray and I have faith that God is a God that He answers prayers, you know. But then many times we forget that our God, Heavenly Father, knows what is better for us. He knows what is behind and in the moment and what it will come. He knows the why we born. He chose us since our mother's womb, and that's what He did in my life. But for a long time, I don't understand that I can do something for God. For a long time in my life, I thought that I was worthless. I thought that I cannot do anything like big for God, or I don't know. I feel like I was not, you know, enough for many things. When I was a little, grew up without parents, without love, without say somebody come over and say, hey, I love you, you know, or my daughter. Being a baby, they killed my dad. So my mom left us. And it was a very difficult situation in my child life. But today I can say, Slava Bogu. I can say glory to God because He's faithful and He saw my heart. He saw me since my mother's womb. And He knew that I have to go through all those difficult situations. So today I can understand those kids that they don't have parents, and those kids that grow up without parents, or maybe they have it, but they left and they stay somewhere else. Today I'm able to understand these babies, and then God saved me and give me a purpose to live, and then give me the love of Christ. And now I'm able to love children, I'm able to love older people, to love young people, like with the love, the clean love that the only Jesus can give us. So through this testimony, it's all glory to God, and to encourage you that if you're going through something, don't worry, put your trust in God. Believe in Jesus Christ. If you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your own Lord and Savior of your life, and you think that you don't have love, and you think that you don't have no purpose in life, or you think that you're not worthy, like I used to thought of my life, I just want to say that Jesus loves you. And then yes, He has something for you. And He loves you very, very much, to the point that He has something prepared for you ahead of you, and when you don't know. So I just want to say, that God don't let me be American citizen because He needs me is Mexican. Now we have a mission over here in Mexico. God will provide mission. And then I just want to say that God has been picking up this place so that way we can have an orphanage for children like kind of like me, that they grew up without parents, that they grew up thinking that there is no love, there is nobody can help us or loves us, you know. And now we can see construction people over here, brothers and sisters from around the place, Russians, Ukrainians, and Mexicans. Like this, that's awesome. Only God can put us together, you know, only Jesus Christ, because He shared His holy blood on the cross, and then His blood united us. So now we can say we are brothers and sisters. Never in my life I thought I was gonna meet the Russian brothers and sisters in Christ, you know, but God is good, God is big, God is awesome, and His love covers everything, and His love healed my heart. His love gave me purpose to keep going. And I just want to say, don't lose courage if you're going through something. And I just want to show you a little bit what God is doing in this place. Everything is still in construction, like you guys see, so everything is not finished. So keep us in prayer. Over here, it will be like for the kids' living room, and like you guys see, our brothers have been working very hard. They came from South Carolina, from the Church Way of Truth, and God will provide San Antonio, California, different places. And over here, like, I just want to show you a little bit. Over here, that we're going to have the sinks for the kids and the stuff. And then I'm just going to keep walking a little bit. And then over here is going to be one of the rooms. Over here, you know, we're going to keep praying, knowing that God will provide. Over here, we're going to have some bunk beds for the children that they will come. You know, we believe that God, this is God's ministry, and He wants children to be happy. He wants children to feel love. He wants children to have that, what I have inside. So I just want to say, if you have the desire to serve one day, come to Matamoros, Mexico, and there's a place for you. And then over here, we have another room, but this is like the for the leaders. And we're gonna have it in this room. The leaders will have their bathroom, a little room, their things, their bed and stuff. And then they will be in charge of the boys. And then we have another side that is for girls. So that way kids will have their building and stuff. And then in a little bit, we're gonna be walking over there when I'm gonna show you guys where we're gonna be at our office, the living room that is gonna be prepared, you know. And then I just wanted you guys to see what God is doing over here. And God has been touching so many hearts that is so, only Jesus can do it, you know. When God will provide ministry, came to Mexico, and I was still here praying to God, I want to serve you, I want to do it, but I don't know how. And one day God bring my pastors from God will provide California, and I was able to be to translate, you know, and I was able to help. And in me, my thought it was, I want to serve God, I'm gonna, you know, unfold some chairs, give waters to people. And I was so happy that I was gonna be able to do something for God. I was not expecting like nothing else. I just want to serve and help, give food to the poor, give love like God did it with me, you know? Like one of the things that God reached me with, it was with his love. And I believe that in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, it talks about love. That you can have all the money, you can have all the wisdom, you can have all the faith, but if you don't have love, we don't have nothing. So this is the other side where there's gonna be a side also for children. We have another room over here that you guys see. Also, you know, it will be like four bunk beds over here, two on each side, and this is gonna be where the kids will be sleeping. And then over here, like a little window so they can, you know, look outside and stuff. And then we also have the area where the bathrooms will be, the showers and everything, you know. Just keep us in your prayers, keep us in your prayers. This is God's ministry, and he's been working. We started the ministry in 2013. Right now we're in 2019, but we can see that God keeps his promises. Many times we want everything fast, you know, but no, we need to know that the time of God is perfect. One day for God is 1,000 years, is what the Bible says. So we just need to be patient, keep praying, keep seeking, keep knocking, and God will do it. God will provide, you know, like a mission called God will provide. And then Jesus is the only way, and there's the only truth, and is the only life. So if you're looking for a way out, Jesus Christ is the way. And here is, like you guys see, it's a big building. It's very beautiful. Praise God for our brothers and sisters that they've been praying for us. Praise God for all the brothers that they've been working hard. I just bring joy to my heart to see that God is faithful. It's right now, like the happiness that I have inside of me, I don't even have enough words to be like, to thank God, you know? It's big for me, so praise God. And here, like you guys, we're gonna be eating together once everything is finished. First God, over here, pretty much the children will be eating, or we're gonna have a church services, or we're gonna have a gathering, like when it's Christmas or what, Thanksgiving, I don't know. And then and the other side over there, we have, this where this, we're gonna have the kitchen, you know? Over there you see, like it's like a window, and from here we will give like the food out for the kids, and then more to there, that room over there is for to save food and stuff. So yeah, this is what God is doing over here in Mexico, and I just want to give the glory to God. Let's go like to the office, like I tell you guys. And then Jesus is good. So anywhere that you are right now, that you're watching this video, I just want to say that Jesus loves you. And then it's something you can do for God. You can pray for us, you know? This, like, things is not, a lot of people think that the money is the everything that you need, but you know what? No. The Bible says in Matthew 6:33, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything else will be given to you. So that's what we do. We seek God, we pray, and then we wait in the Lord. See, over here we have our brothers keep working. In this area over here is gonna be the living room. The living room where we're gonna receive families that they will come over to check out, you know, how they can receive help. Over here in Matamoros, Mexico, we have orphanages, but this orphanage, once when God already activated to start working, we have a lot of kids over here. in this part of Mexico, that their parents, they like go, and then they're drug addicts, they have problems, or other moms that they don't have no money. Like they can be like 15-year-old mama, 16-year-old mama, they don't have money to feed the children. And then they bring it to these places, like the one that God has opened it up over here, so they can receive the help, the food, the everything that they need. And then I just want to say that God is good, and praise God, because He's the one that opened these places for children like that. And I'm happy for that. I'm very, very happy. You know, many times I'm like, Lord, You're so good. I don't deserve to be here seeing so much of Your glory in this earth, but God loves us very much and give us this privilege to be here, you know. I just want to walk out a little bit over here. And then I just want to remind you guys that prayers are powerful. Over here in this land, maybe in the future we will have it, like to build something here to play basketball, football, I don't know. God is working, God is in the move. Like I said, we've been in this construction for 6 years. But this place, it was donated to the mission, it was like just like a hole with garbage. They have to put like 100 trucks with dust and then compact everything, and then a little bit by little bit we see how God is moving and His faithfulness, you know. So I just want to encourage you once again that if God, you know, with my mistakes or with my goodness, God forgive my sins, I accept Him as my Lord and Savior in my heart, and then after that He filled me with His love, and now I'm able to work for His kingdom in this earth. And I know that over here, I don't know how long I'm gonna live, but the like Apostle Paul said, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain.